Prayer is one of the major armors that the church need to be consistent in. Prayer. Now, why we must put on these armors? We also established last week that there is four forces that Paul revealed in the book of Ephesians 6. Four forces. He says that, first of all, he tells us that we wrestle not against flesh and blood. That means that what you are up against tonight are not human. It's not flesh and blood. What you are up against tonight, it is not flesh and blood. Because our fight is not with human. We fight the most, we fight with folks. When Paul says, we wrestle not against flesh and blood. But number one, against prince. And what we say principality is? Amen. A fallen angel. And also principality is what? High ranking spirit. So saints of God, this principality are not weak. It's high in rank. So it have ranks. And principalities will govern region. We can find it out in the Bible tonight. Principality job is to govern region. So they operate in region. So amen. They control nation. Amen. He said principalities, and then he says what? Power. Number two, power. So the principality enforce power. Amen. Power. So you got a principality that enforcing. Amen. And number three, what we say? And rulers of the darkness of what? That means this word right here. The rulers of the darkness of this world. This present time that we are living in. Amen. This is why most Christians, if they don't understand what they're up against, they will not know how to be successful in fighting it. You can fight who would you recognize and understand. You got to know how he operates. You got to know how the enemy operates. Until you understand how he operates, you'll not be able to stop him. Amen. Now we're gonna. And he says what? Rulers of the darkness of this world. And what? And what the next one? Spiritual wickedness in high places. Now, this demon operates, the spirit operates in the rulers. In the rulers. That rules this world. Operates in rulers. That sitting in high places. So Paul is telling the church of Ephesians, he says, now, you are up against a principality. And he used the word wrestle. Because if you study it and you really do the history, they know what Paul was talking about. Because in during that time, their custom was wrestling. So when Paul said wrestle, automatically they understood. Paul spoke in a language that they can understand. And so they'll be able, then now he says, okay, amen. Now you know that you are not wrestling against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against power, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Then Paul says, wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the last and evil days. And I've done all but to stand. But you can't stand if you're not dressed with the seven armors that the church need to be dressed with seven armors that the child of God need to have on, seven armors. Now, yes, deal with, yes, I'm going to work tonight, and I'm going to show you why that we need to have on the armors of God. You need to have the armor of God. You need to put on the whole armor of God. And there's seven armors. They say six, but it's seven. They leave out prayer. And when the Bible says, man ought to pray, no, when he feel like. Always. So prayer is one of the major key. One of the major armor that we must engage in prayer. We must engage in prayer. Amen. Let's go. Our first. Let's go to Matthew 12 and verse 43. Matthew chapter 12 and verse 43. Now, let me make my case. I'm going to establish truth. Because we said a great lawyer doesn't win cases because of the certificate that he have on the wall. But a great lawyer wins cases because what? He presents evidence. So yes, present some evidence tonight. Do you want to see some evidence? Amen. Amen. Yes, amen. Come on, yes, with me. Amen. 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 I pray. My prayers tonight, that the eyes of your understanding will be enlightened, that you will know what is the hope of his calling and what is the richness of his inheritance in the saints. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. And in Matthew chapter 12, everybody, turn your Bible. You got to see it. You got to see it for yourself. Matthew chapter 12 and verse 43. If you haven't, say amen. If you haven't, say wait. Matthew 12, verse 43. Amen.
When the unclean spirit is going out of a man, he walketh through dry places seeking rest and finding none.
You hear that? When the unclean spirit comes out of a man, he walk in dry places seeking rest. You remember we established last week that a principality is not a demon, it's a fallen spirit, right? A fallen angel, right? Amen? And the difference between a fallen angel and a demon does not win. They walk in dry places. Principalities have wings. A demon is for truth. That walk in dry places. The Bible says, Jesus says, amen, when an unclean spirit come out of a man, what he does, he walk in dry places. Now, just remember, demon is not effective until they have a human body to work through. They must have a human body to make the work true in order for them to be effective. And last week we says also, if they don't find a human body, they will sell it for animal. They need a body. Because they are not legal if they don't operate in a physical vessel. So their job is to try getting you. That's why they seek to possess humans. Amen. Yeah. Verse 24. Yeah, verse 24.
Then he says, I will return.
So a demon have a personality. They can speak. They talk. Then this is the spirit of sin. What the spirit is saying?
Then he said,
he is the spirit. What he said?
I
will return into my house. He's calling the body that he came out of his home.
Yes. From which I came out.
Uh-huh.
And when he is come, he finds it empty.
And when he come in the house, he find it empty. That means what happened? You empty. See, the demon come out, but you ain't putting nothing in. The demon come out, but you ain't putting no word in. So when he come back, it's empty. So what he does?
Then he goes and takes with him
seven other spirits.
Now he go for his buddies.
He gonna call seven of his buddies more wicked than him.
And they enter in.
Okay.
And dwell there.
And they dwell there. The word dwell means to take up residence. That becomes their home. That becomes their habitat.
And at the
last day,
is worse than the first.
That means that man or that woman, the last day is going to be worse than the first.
Jesus. Even so, it be also unto the wicked generation.
My God. Amen. Now, there's something that I want you to see tonight. Let's go in Daniel chapter 10 and verse 1. We can start from 1, because 1 I better understand it. Now.
Daniel 10:1.
Yes.
In the third year of Cyrus.